الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا تجعل الحزن والصعب إذا ما شئت سهلا. In the fifth night of the month of Ramadan, we continue our reminders and reflections on some of the ayat of the Quran. We mentioned that the first chapter of the Quran, Allah Azza wa Jalla Surah Al-Baqarah introduces ahkam and explains for us that the essence of these ahkam is not only to follow rules but to achieve the taqwa. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ لَيْسَ الْبِرَّ أَن تُوَلُّوا وُجُوهَكُمْ قِبَلَ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ أَنْ وَأُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْمُتَّقُونَ. And this one of the beauties of being muttaqi and conscious of applying these rules and the boundaries is that your dua will be accepted by Allah Azza wa Jal, and you will be from those who are connected with Allah Azza wa Jal in their dua. And that's why Surah Al-Baqarah concluded with a dua, and Surah Al-Imran started with a dua and also concluded with a dua. Now, Surah An-Nisa is a beautiful chapter in the Quran that continues the same theme. The theme that there are, you know, regulations and rules that needs to be observed. But this time, Allah Azza wa Jal give more emphasis to regulations and rules about the blood, the rahim, and those who are undermined in the societies, the Nisa and the orphans. But Allah starts the chapter by reminding us about an important fact. يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا وَبَثَّ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي تَسَاءَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامِ إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. Allah Azza reminds us about the fact that we are all from one origin, Adam عليه السلام. We are all brothers and sisters as a human living on this earth, so we need to be mindful of that. Allah Azza wa Jalla in this chapter introduces the ahkam of the nisa. وَأَتُوا النِّسَاءَ صَدَقَاتُهُنَّ نِحْلَةً وَابْتُوا الْيَتَامَى حَتَّى إِذَا بَلَغُوا النِّكَاحَ فَإِنْ آنَسْتُم مِّنْهُمْ رُشْدًا فَادْفَعُوا عَلَيْهِمْ أَمْوَالَهُمْ and then يُوصِيكُمُ اللَّهُ فِي أَوْلَادِكُمْ لِلذَّكَرِ مِثْلُ حَظِّ الْأُنثَيَيْنِ and then at the end of these, rules and regulations that enhance and improves and protect the rights of the arham, those who are around us, mainly those who are undermined under of the nisa and the orphans and the and those who are unable to protect themselves and speak out for themselves. Allah Azza says at the end of these, regulations and rules, that's تِلْكَ حُدُودُ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ يُدْخِلْهُ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا ذَلِكَ الْفَوْزُ الْعَظِيمُ. And then the opposite is true. وَمَنْ يَعْصِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ يُدْخِلْهُ نَارًا خَالِدًا فِيهَا وَلَهُ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ. So be careful. These rules that Allah Azza wa Jal presents to you in the Quran is for you to apply, to protect the rights of the undermines. And if you are to apply them, then your rewards will be Al-Jannah. And quite the opposite. Those who undermine the rights and of their sisters or the orphans, then eventually the consequences for doing that will be severe in the hereafter. And then after that, Allah Azza also presents another important fact that following the rules and regulations that Allah Azza presents is presenting to you are not an option for you, not a choice. You need to be assertive, and you need to have be passionate about them and not to flip flop, because Allah Azza says, "Alam tara alladhina yaz'umuna annahum amanu bima unzila ilayka yuriduna an yatahakamu ila at-taghut wa qad wa ma unzila min qablika yuriduna an yatahakamu ila at-taghut wa yuridu ash-shaytanu an yudhillahum dalalan ba'ida." Allah Azza says, did you not see those who claim to believe in what has been revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and revealed to and believe in what has been revealed to the previous prophets before him, and then you read on at-tahakum al-taghut, referring to incidents that took place in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when some of the people who are governed by the regulations and rules of the Prophet ﷺ in Medina want to avoid following the ahkam of Islam and wants to change for better choice for them. And then after that, Allah Azza wa Jal you know, throughout the surah also, presents another important fact. فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِي مَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَجْدُ فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتُ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying that, you know, by Allah, they are unable to believe. They are not able to achieve the taqwa حتى يحكموك فيما شجر بينهم, until they govern you, ya Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and come to you when it comes to their disputes among themselves. ثم لجدوا في أنفسهم حرجا مما قضيت ويسلموا تسليما, and they should not be having any feelings in their hearts for your rulings, ya Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, ويسلموا تسليما, and they should be submitting to the will of Allah عز وجل and to the rules of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This incident took a place when there was a dispute between the cousin of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and one of the people in Medina, and then when they came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave the ruling, and then the man was upset, said that you gave this ruling because he's your cousin. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was so upset, and then he said, if I am not just, who would be exercising justice? And then Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed this ayah to say that you are unable to become mu'min, true believer in Allah Azza wa Jalla, unless you submit to the will of Allah Azza wa Jalla and to the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then Allah says, وَلَوْ أَنَّ كَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمُ أَنْ يَقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ أَوْ أُخْرِجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ مَا فَعَلُوهُ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا مِنْهُمْ وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ فَعَلُوا مَا يُعَظُونَ بِهِ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ وَأَشَدَّ تَثْبِيتًا. And Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, I want you to follow the teachings of the Quran and to the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And if we were to ask you to kill yourselves or to go out of your town, then many of you would not be able to do it. The rules of the deen are simple, and they are there to enhance your life and the life of the others around you. And be mindful that if you were to do what you have been advised to, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ فَعَلُوا مَا يُعَظُونَ بِهِ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ, this would be better for them. وَأَشَدَّ تَثْبِيتًا, and that would help you to steadfast on the right path. We're living in the time of fitan, and the time of difficulties and challenges, and we're always struggling to stay on the right path. This is one of the ways that will help you to stay on the right path, to follow the teachings of the commands of Allah Azza wa Jalla and the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَإِذَا لَآتَيْنَاهُمْ مِنْ لَدُنَّ أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. And if you were to follow the commands of Allah Azza wa Jalla and the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then Allah Azza wa Jalla will be giving you أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا, a huge reward. وَلَهَدَيْنَاهُمْ صِرَاطًا مُسْتَقِيمًا, and will guide you to the straight path. This is one of the avenues, following the teachings of Allah and the rules of Allah and the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is one of the ways to help you to stay on the right path, show you and guide you on the path of Allah Azza wa Jalla. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ يُدْخِلْهُ جَنَّاتٍ وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَأُولَئِكَ مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. And then Allah Azza wa Jal, present this ayah as a gift to the Sahaba who were living with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and to us who are coming after them. This ayah was revealed when Thawban radiyallahu anhu, who was the servant of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was once sick, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam missed him and inquired about him, and he found out that he was sick. And then when he came to see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, "Ya Rasulullah, I love you so much and enjoy your company. And when I am with you, I am so excited and happy. And when I leave you, I become so sad. And then I realized and remembered that one day I will die and you will die, Ya Rasulullah. And then, your status in al-akhirah is way much higher than my status if I were to be able to make it to al-jannah." The Prophet ﷺ did not have an answer to Thawban until this ayah was revealed to explain to everyone that وَمَنْ يُطْعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَأُولَئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ, whoever obey Allah Azza wa Jal and his Prophet, then will be in the company of those whom Allah Azza wa Jal bestowed his ni'am, blessings on, من النبيين, from the prophets, والصديقين, righteous, والصالحين, والشهداء والصالحين, وحسن أولئك رفيقا, and there is no company or better company than the company of the above mentioned. May Allah Azza wa Jal the Mighty make us from those who would not only be aware of the teachings of the rules of Allah Azza wa Jalla and the teachings of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, but also apply them compassionately in our life so that we're able to be in the company of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the hereafter. Allahumma ameen wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.